This is the Wyze application for the Wyze color bulbs. I have number 4 and number 3 here at the top and a grouping that I've made down here. And if I toggle them, you can see they're slightly off camera. In fact, here, if we move that a little closer, you'll actually see some of the things that I'm talking about while I'm toggling it on and off, only because I have my spotlights on. So as you saw right from the home screen, you can click it on and off and it will change to an on or off position and remember the last color that you had it set for. Opening up the Wyze bulb itself, you'll notice this screen looks a little familiar. In fact, if you have a regular Wyze bulb review over there in the corner, you're familiar with this screen, which is the color temperature setting. Well, they've redesigned this since I did my review of the original Wyze bulbs. Here on this screen, you have an on-off button, which I will select, and you can see the light is on. I left it as green just to make it easier to see, but now we have a sliding toggle right here. Ooh, I changed the color. There is a sliding toggle here, which allows you to adjust the brightness of the bulb from this screen. And then just like with the original bulb, you can select what kind of color temperature you would like. Right now I'm on cool white, I can bring it up to warm, daylight. You get the idea. This part is the same as the old bulbs, the color portion. So let's bring us over to the color. Here you have a dynamic color wheel that will allow us to select colors. And you can see just how quickly that color in the upper right-hand corner there is changing based on where I'm placing that color wheel. On this page too, we have a bar that we can drag to lower and raise the brightness of that particular bulb. Scrolling down, we have individual scenes. Each scene is dependent on the number of bulbs that you have. In this particular one, you've got color temperature scenes: nightlight, cozy, bright, energized. And you'll notice there's a little singular dot in the corner indicating one, because these bulbs are not grouped together. They're just acting as a single bulb. With the color, you also have energized, gaming, movie, and meditation. So selecting these changes the color of the bulb depending on whatever scene you have selected, and obviously it would override the color that you have. Now I mentioned that it's based on groupings or single bulbs. Notice this one has a singular dot. But if I come over here to my bedroom group, I actually created a Christmas grouping and you can see two distinct dots there, green and red. That's because one bulb I have set to green, the other I have set to red, and it spans between the two. Likewise, coming down to the energizing, it's a little easier to see in like the purple range. You have two dots and then it washes between the two. So you get an effect kind of like this if I turn on the Christmas one, seeing it between the two. The more bulbs that you have as part of a group, the more dots that you'll see across and the more transition you'll see amongst all of the bulbs, which is kind of interesting. Coming back to our Wyze bulb, we talked about changing the color, we talked about the temperature, turning on and off brightness, and then down with our scenes. The scenes, just like the original bulbs, I have a little qualm with, and that is if I try and set a scene up, notice there's nothing here that says I'm setting a scene. I have to change a color, change the brightness. So if we come up here, change the brightness to 44%, I then have to come to scene and select save, which will allow me to edit an existing scene or save this as a new scene. I really wish that there was a plus sign or something here for adding a scene to make that more easy to discern. And we're gonna come back up here and put it back to green. And we're going to drop that up to 100%. And we're gonna talk about this up here, which is the overall settings for the individual Wyze bulbs. Selecting this will allow us to come into the settings. You can see here we have our device name. I just cheated and left it at Wyze bulb. You can edit that as you like. You also have the option for device icons. Here you have many choices that you can pick from depending on where this is and what it's doing. I'm going to select back and move down to schedules and automations. If you're familiar with any of the other Wyze products, here you'll be able to schedule automation. So turn on at this time, turn off at this time. If this action with the Wyze cam happens, then this turns on and does something. That is where you get all of that stuff from, schedule and automation. Sleep routines, set up. You can have a wake up and a bedtime, and selecting, hypothetically we'll do a bedtime, you do a duration, you do a time start, and then you can select days that you wish it to occur. What this will do is simulate the sunset to help you fall asleep faster. So if you're one of those people like me who stays up much later than you should be, this will allow you to dim the lights without you having to think about it to force you to kind of go to bed at a regular time. Next we have timers, which at current date of filming, my bulbs are supposed to be up to date, but that is not allowing me to access it. So no timer. It worked before. It does not work now, whether or not you want it to turn itself off in 30 minutes or turn itself on in 30 minutes. Vacation mode? Well, turning this on will mimic actual activity with the bulb. So it will turn itself on and off randomly to mimic somebody actually being in the home. Sun match, turning this on, worked again originally, but apparently after the firmware upgrade does not. It would match the color temperature of bulbs to the daylight outside, sunset, sunrise. Scenes, if we had any scenes created, and for this particular bulb I don't, you would see a listing of them here. Power loss recovery. This is one of the things that I think separates Wyze bulbs from a lot of the other smart bulbs out there, and that is power loss recovery. Well, guess what? You can tell it what the bulb does when power is lost and then return. So if you're like me and you lose power at 5 p.m. and the power is restored at 3 a.m. and don't want your Wyze bulb to turn on at 3 a.m., you can select that here. So in my case, I have it on because again, this is a test bulb that the power will restore itself to the on state. I can select maintain previous state, which is if the bulb is off, it will return to being off. If the bulb is on, it will return to being on. Beneficial. Happy they have that. Backing up. Share this device. You can share this device just like you can share all other Wyze products with somebody else who has a Wyze account. Device info. And the only reason I'm bringing this up is to show the current firmware version that is causing me trouble. But this is where you find out all the device info of your particular Wyze bulb. And then you have Wyze support, which is built in for the Wyze bulb right into the application itself. I really like that they're doing this to keep everything in one place. And then here we can say check for firmware. As you can see, everything's good and those are kind of broken. So depending on how quickly I get this out, perhaps Wyze will have fixed that. If not, Wyze, see that firmware? Fix it. And then down here, you can delete the device. One thing to notice is this icon up here. As we change it, it dynamically changes to the actual color of the bulb. So you will always know what the bulb color is right here. And if I turn that off, it will go back to gray. This will be how to create a group for your Wyze color bulbs. Now, I do have a group set up right here, bedroom light. However, I have the other two that are not in a group. The one issue that I have with the color bulbs versus the old regular bulbs that you can't get anymore is that you cannot create a group with the bulbs, with the color bulbs, and the old classic bulbs. But there's nothing we can do about that. So we are going to come up to the plus sign and we are going to say add device group. We can come down to pick our individual bulbs. Here you can see color grouping or classic grouping. If I were to come up here and tap on this, I only see a listing of my classics, not the color bulbs, and only those that are not already part of a group. Now I'm going to come back over here and I'm going to select my two color bulbs that are not part of a grouping here. So click, click, and then we give it a name, which is test group, and then select done. What that does is now that links those two together. Notice test group takes the place of the two individual bulbs, and I have the bulbs situated just off camera. So if I turn that on, you can see green and red. And if I turn them off, should you want to turn off a group, you simply select the group, but we come up here, lighting in this group, we click on this, select edit, and then we can select a red mark, which would remove one of the bulbs from the grouping. Coming back, if we select an individual bulb, you see the device information, and we're just gonna come back, go into the grouping one more time, remove one of the bulbs. Notice they have these double arrows over here, so you can actually drag those into any order that you want. We're gonna select done, and then come back to the main page, where you see test group still exists, but we now have individual control over my red bulb. Selecting the test group will only turn on the green bulb right now because there's no other items in that group. If we wanted to remove even the singular bulb in here, we simply come into edit, remove, and then yes, done. And now there are no bulbs associated with the test group. So notice we still have test grouping, but the bulbs are no longer part of it. If we wanted to get rid of test group, we come up here, edit devices. Here's our test group, selecting the red icon, yes, delete, and done. That grouping no longer exists, and we're back to our individual bulbs. So that has been a look at the Wyze Color Bulb and what you can do with the application for it. I will admit, it is much more simplified than I thought it would be for the color bulbs, and I do like the scenes that you can make them, but I wish they were a little easier to create without having to select something and then say save. I want that plus sign, Wyze. But that has been the longer than I thought look at the Wyze application for the Wyze Color Bulb.